Good morning, dear students. We have already discussed three separation methods. First one, hand picking. Second one, threshing. And third one, winnowing. And today we are going to discuss other four methods: sieving, sedimentation, decantation, and filtration. Please watch this video.
You might have seen your mother is doing like this. Do you know why she is doing like this? Yes, to remove impurities present in the flour. This method is called sieving. It is a simple technique for separating particles of different sizes. Sieving is used when components of a mixture have different sizes. Sieving allows the fine flour particles to pass through the holes of the sieve, while the bigger impurities remain on the sieve. The first one is sieving usually we are doing in our kitchen. And the second and third one is sieving at construction area. Why we are doing this sieving at construction area? Do you know? Yes, to separate pebbles and stones from sand. So the fine sand particles pass through the holes of the sieve while the bigger stones remain on the sieve. So it's very easy to separate stones from sand. And the fifth process is sedimentation and sixth one is decantation. Sometimes it may not be possible to separate components of a mixture by winnowing and hand picking. For example, there may be lighter impurities like dust or soil particles in rice or pulses. So how can we separate these impurities? Rice or pulses are usually washed before cooking, isn't it? So when you add water to these, the impurities like dust, soil particles get separated. Now we can see the heavier rice settle at the bottom. This process is called sedimentation. Then we can see water at the top. When the water is removed, that process is called decantation. Let us define the process sedimentation and decantation. First, sedimentation, when the heavier component in a mixture settles down after water is added to it. The process is called sedimentation. I think it's clear for you. The next one is decantation, the process in which water is removed without disturbing the sediment is called decantation. And this decantation process is also used to separate two immiscible liquids. That is an example here, oil and water. They form different layers and it is easy to separate oil from the top. Take a glass of water and add soil to it. This soil will settle down after some time. That process is sedimentation. Now we can remove this water by this process, that is decantation. Okay, and after this decantation we will get soil in one glass and water in another glass. Okay, but this water still has finer impurities, so soil has separated and water still has finer impurities in the second glass. Now we have to separate these finer impurities. For that one, you have to take another glass and place a filter paper at the top. A filter paper is a paper that has fine pores. Pores means holes. Then the mixture is then poured on the filter paper. And solid particles in the mixture do not pass through it and remain on the filter, and we will get clear water or pure water in the glass. And this process is called filtration. Filtration is a method for separating an insoluble solid from a liquid by passing it through a medium, that is filter paper. And filtration is used to separate pulp and seeds from the juice. And it is also used to separate cheese or paneer from milk. Do you know what is insoluble solid? Insoluble solid means not dissolving in water. So filtration is a method to separate insoluble solid from water. The second one, no, we have already discussed. It is used to separate pulp and seeds from the juice, because this pulp and seeds are insoluble. It is easy to separate pulp and seed from juice by filtration.